of a killer earthquake. More than 6,000 people were killed in the Great Hanshin earthquake. Joanne Wong has the story.
It's a day of high emotions for the relatives and friends of victims of the Great Hanshin earthquake. At a park in hard-hit Kobe, mourners used candlelight to piece together January 17, 1995, the day that changed their lives. This man said time has stopped for him since that fateful day. The magnitude 7.3 tremor hit Hyogo Prefecture at 5:46 a.m., causing widespread devastation in the area. More than 6,000 lives were lost and 40,000 people were injured. It's one of the deadliest earthquakes in Japan's history. Painful memories for these mourners here as they looked at the names of the dead inscribed on the walls of a memorial. Japan's Crown Prince and Prime Minister Yukio Hatoyama were among those who paid their respects at an official ceremony. They also called on survivors to stay strong. Joanne Wong, TVB News.
Japan has warned of action if China starts gas production in a disputed gas field in the East China Sea. According to Kyoto News Agency, Japanese Foreign Minister Katsuya Okada raised the issue during a meeting in Tokyo with his Chinese counterpart Yang Jiechi. Quoting a Japanese foreign ministry official, the report says Okada mentioned certain counteraction but did not elaborate. Sovereignty over the sea area around the Chunshou gas field, known in Japan as Shirakaba, has long been disputed. The area has an estimated reserve of 92 million barrels of oil equivalent, but both countries believe there may be larger hidden reserves. Beijing and Tokyo reached a broad agreement in 2008 on principles to jointly develop gas fields there. But progress has been slow and Japan has accused China of drilling for gas in violation of the deal. And coming up after the break, a man injured in a torch explosion. An accident involving...
油厂元村村民说，五接受清拆会坚持到最后一刻。油麻地一座大厦火烛，一个婆婆吸入浓烟，不惜送院。海地救灾进度缓慢，治安急剧恶化，八个中国维和人员证实全部遇难。
欢迎收睇新闻最前线，我系黄巧，
我系曾美华。
反高铁示威者昨晚包围立法会，直到凌晨先至散去。期间，运输及房屋局局长郑宇华一度被困。局方发言人就话，郑宇华有谂过同示威者对话，但系警方考虑到安全问题，冇安排到。而立法会主席曾钰成就话，郑宇华同部分议员系依法履行职责，佢唔认同示威者嘅做法。由林永恩报道。
郑宇华喺财委会通过拨款之后，大约夜晚7点几准备离开立法会，但示威者堵塞通道，要求同佢对话。运输及房屋局话，郑宇华有谂过同示威者见面，但同警方商量之后，考虑到示威者当时情绪高涨，警方认为唔适合，各人要折返立法会。 5个钟之后，大批警员开路护送。
多位支持撥款嘅議員一齊落咗最近嘅港鐵站，搭尾班車離開。期間，黃義宏被教進掟中個頭。立法會主席曾鈺成話：唔認同示威者圍堵立法會，阻礙官員同埋議員係離開呢，我唔能夠認同呢個做法，因為呢，官員同埋議員都係依法履行佢哋嘅職責。 投票贊成嘅議員呢，亦都係反映咗社會上邊，起碼係大部分嘅市民嘅意見。
佢又話：財委會主席已經盡力主持會議，佢唔評論係咪有議員為咗拖延時間而提問，但就話議員係有發言權，亦都冇收到有人提出要修改議事規則。有線電視記者林永恩報道。
昨日包圍立法會的示威者有大批80後青年，他們由哪些人號召？為何會突然間對高鐵撥款這麼關心？又是否會成為新的社會運動力量呢？許秋霞和策劃行動的80後青年傾過。
反高鐵示威由80後的後生仔發起。1982年出世的陈景辉是反高铁大联盟的核心成员，他形容包围立法会是经过精心部署。
我们只是拉开一些铁马，那些铁马如果不拉开，我们的部署就会失败，即是说在主要的汽车进出口阻止郑裕华离开，要求一个公众对话，只是十几分钟，而家被标签为暴力的那个时刻都没有暴力发生过。真正在肉体身上施加暴力的是差人的胡椒喷雾。
虽然通过了高铁拨款，但他们会好像保卫天星码头咁保卫菜园村。
菜园村是坚持不切不拆，我们一定会这样做。我哋放學放假，日日就蒲商場。我哋由細到大都係咁蒲，冇記憶嘅。我哋成長嘅時候就係沒有一片菜園，沒有一片社區。
有份策劃行動嘅有100人左右，號召到咁多人參加係靠互聯網同短片。有學者亦都收到 Facebook 群組嘅邀請，相信呢種會成為群眾運動嘅新力量。
有很多走出嚟的年輕人咧，其實就唔係話俾啲咩政黨啊、政團啊咁組織，有較大的空間咧，俾一啲比較獨立啊、比較不受任何即係既定嘅既有勢力支配嘅一啲即係組群咧，去表達佢哋嘅意見。
佢又話：今次高鐵撥款暴露咗好多政府施政嘅問題，係對年青一代一個政治啟蒙。有線電視記者許秋霞報導。
高鐵撥款通過之後，菜園村會面臨清拆，有村民說堅持到最後一刻不遷不拆。黃志康報導。
在菜園村住了幾十年的游叔下午專門拎啲竹到立法會為斷食的幾位青年打氣。高鐵上馬，游叔堅持不遷不拆。
講道理呢，我們已經忍了一年了，我哋嗰啲市民同埋啲學生支持我，我哋睇見咁樣咧，我哋都好難過，多謝佢哋支持。
撥款通過嘅消息好快傳到入村，喺度長大嘅曹小姐當時一聽到，即時喊咗出嚟。
好可惜咯，即係我哋條村要拆咯，同埋屋企亦都要剷平啊。咁嗰一刻咧，你係根本好難，即係你好難控制你自己啲情緒啊咁咯。
村民都希望特首和局長可以入村和他們見面。村民說菜園村這裡還有70多戶拒絕登記接受賠償，部分村民說政府肯將登記期限吞到下個月底，可以給多些時間他們商討下一步行動，都算是件好事。有線電視記者黃志康報導。
行政會議召集人梁振英說，政府應該認真總結高鐵事件，執行的時候要更加慎重和改善諮詢工作。
譬如話收地嘅時候，係咪可以盡量收少啲？喺收地嘅過程當中咧，係咪可以盡量通融啲？日後其他嘅大型嘅建設項目咧，我睇政府都要吸取今次嗰個經驗，總結跟今次嘅經驗。譬如喺溝通嗰方面、諮詢嗰方面，係應該做更加做得好啲。
油麻地一座大厦下午发生火警，一个婆婆吸入浓烟不舒服要送院。起火单位的男户主一度以为爸爸被困屋入面，事后证实无事。冼晴峰报道。
起火的是大厦15楼一个单位，现场火光红红，冒出黑烟。又傳出爆炸聲，仲不斷有雜物跌落街。消防員升起雲梯灌救，多個單位住客被困，要消防員協助。
Let's go President Deng Yuk Sing said it was inevitable that a public works project as big as the express rail link would create divisions within society. But the pro-government lawmaker said he found it unacceptable that protesters had shown hostility towards legislators who voted for the railway because they were only doing their duty. He insisted their views reflected the majority of the public. Jeff Tang, ATV News.
Turning to other news, the bodies of 8 Chinese peacekeepers have been found among the ruins of the UN headquarters in Haiti, which collapsed in a massive earthquake 4 days ago.
In the absence of police and peacekeeping forces, violence has broken out in the capital as survivors waiting for aid are getting more desperate. ATV's Su Qingtai reports.
It was a solemn moment as Chinese rescue workers and surviving peacekeepers bowed to the bodies of their 8 compatriots to pay their last respects. After more than 80 hours of search and rescue operations around the collapsed UN headquarters in Port-au-Prince, Chinese and Brazilian rescue workers discovered the first body on Friday night. The remaining 7 bodies were found at dawn yesterday local time, 3 days after Haiti was devastated by a magnitude 7 earthquake. The 8 Chinese police peacekeepers were part of a 125-strong force deployed by Beijing through the UN. They had been in a meeting with UN envoy Hedi Anabi when the earthquake hit, toppling the 5-story building and burying them under the rubble. China has sent a chartered plane to Haiti with emergency supplies and a 60-member rescue team, which is currently working on the ground. Around 9,000 UN peacekeepers have provided security in the Caribbean country since a 2004 uprising ousted the previous president. In the absence of police forces, violence is breaking out among the increasingly desperate survivors. A fight erupted in a Haitian relief camp when aid supplies boxes were dropped from a helicopter and people scrambled over each other to get their hands on the goods. Elsewhere on a central commercial street, a mob of armed looters fought to grab shirts, bags, toys and any other items they could find in houses and shops destroyed by the quake. A few arrests were made, but the violence is growing with the desperation of survivors who are hungry, homeless and still waiting for aid. A German search and rescue team arrived yesterday to assist in aid efforts but had to postpone its first mission by a day due to a lack of security personnel. Although donations and rescue workers have been pouring in from many countries, including China, the US, Germany, France, Bolivia, South Korea and Mexico, it seems little help has arrived in downtown Port-au-Prince. These children from an orphanage in the district survived the earthquake, which killed 50 of their classmates. While corpses are everywhere, thousands of bodies are believed to be buried under the rubble, and relatives hope they can still dig out their family members alive. This woman says she has been trying to find help to no avail. Since the day of the earthquake, I've been walking up and down the streets looking for help, but it never comes, she said. My aunt lives down the street and I know she and many others are under the rubble there. Officials estimate around 50,000 bodies have been collected and the final death toll is expected to be between 100,000 and 200,000. Su Qingtai, ATV News.
And the UN has confirmed that its mission chief in Haiti, his deputy and its acting police commissioner were all killed in the earthquake.
U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton has proposed that her government and Haiti set up a joint unit to provide aid to the quake victims.
U.S. Secretary of State Hillary Clinton was the first senior Western official to arrive in the Haitian capital, Port-au-Prince, yesterday. With her came relief supplies as America poured aid into the shattered Caribbean country. Clinton told Haitians they could count on U.S. support.
We will be here today, tomorrow, and for the time ahead. I know of the great resilience and strength.
Marked the 15th anniversary.
反高鐵示威者包圍立法會，鄭宇華被困5個鐘頭之後，深夜先至能夠離開。 喺海地失踪嘅8个中国维和人员证实全部罹难，当地物资短缺，爆发抢掠同逃亡潮。各位欢迎收睇呢一节新闻，我系李朗怡。立法会财委会通过高铁669亿元拨款，反高铁示威者由寻日挨晚开始多次冲击警方防线，警方要使用胡椒喷雾。 衝突入面有4男1女警員受傷，示威者方面就冇人向警方報告受傷。反高鐵大聯盟聲稱有逾萬人參與集會，警方就指集會高峰期有1700幾人，警方並強烈譴責擾亂公眾秩序嘅行為。
撥款通過後，部分反高鐵人士走到遮打道，
唔使你隨時都會離開，我哋一定要團結。
他們拉扯鐵馬，警員要用胡椒噴霧，場面混亂。部分示威者用水冲块面，有人企图冲入立法会，过百个防暴警察拎住圆形同长盾牌增援。另一批示威者在側臣道集結，不讓官員和部分議員離開，他們坐在地下，警員七點多開始清場，逐個抬走，有示威者逼向运输及房屋局局长郑宇华架车，要同佢对话。议员同样被困。示威者拎走铁马做路障。又占据一段德辅道中。清場行動受阻，
希望你們能夠冷靜些。
反對撥款的議員亦勸喻示威者克制，
我們都是要尊重我們立法會，我們立法會的言論的自由，我們的社會的安寧。
反高鐵停撥款大聯盟發表聲明，說市民集會合情合理，批評警方暴力清場。
為什麼他在數以萬計市民和平理性形式底下要求政府撤回高铁拨款方案，仍然是被一小撮横逆民意的保皇党议员强行通过的情况下，演变成为警察以暴力清场的混乱场面。
警方强烈谴责破坏社会安宁和扰乱公众秩序的行为，强调绝对不会容忍任何蓄意的暴力。无线电视记者方东升报道。
反高铁示威者和警方多次冲突之后，凌晨撤回皇后像广场，之后陆续散去。而运输及房屋局局长郑宇华被困立法会五个钟头之后，深夜由警员护送下离开。
郑宇华走不到，被困车内个半钟头之后，折返立法会大楼。
多谢大家关心啊！
直到午夜过后，大批警员组成人链，护送郑宇华等官员和其他建制派议员离开，入了去港铁中环站搭尾班车。有议员说部分示威者企图阻止他们离开。
我们排着队一个跟一个走，就由正门走出来，转左，转了左之后走几步，那么嘣一声就有个人就不知道哪个，我真的看不到，就掟了我的左边的后脑，那些胶樽里头的水呢就淋湿了我的膊头，冇事的。
其他议员同埋局长有冇受伤呢？
冇啊，因为我要大挡住他们，哎呀，冇事的，冇事的，你关心。
我哋冇可能坐到过夜噶嘛，因为第日又有其他工作做，所以就同警方倾过要立法安排我哋走咯。咁後嚟就警方就話：，你哋喺度等啦， 我哋盡量安排啦，保護住咁落去搭地鐵啦，用個最近最短嘅路落去地鐵啦。
通道
俾你落。係啊，佢再開咗個通道俾我哋落去。我哋一齊去到金鐘站，咁然後我哋就上落車啦，然後落車就上翻去地面就轉車啦。
期間大批防暴警察在遮打道和側臣道布防，示威者不滿鄭宇華沒有直接對話，佔據了遮打道和德輔道中六個多小時的示威者凌晨點幾退回去皇后像廣場繼續集會。
經過連日的抗爭，大聯盟說抗爭還未完，接下來他們會總結經驗並且收集大家的聯絡方法繼續反高鐵。無線電視記者林子豪報導。
而今朝仍然有幾名唔食嘢嘅示威者留守喺皇后像廣場，佢哋計劃唔食嘢到下晝。另外有幾十人在場聲援。至於尋日因為受示威者包圍，立法會外一度要封閉嘅道路，已經喺凌晨2:20全部重開。高鐵項目獲得撥款，政府承諾一系列措施，包括延長菜園村村民登記期限，又研究撥款俾區議會為受影響嘅大角咀居民聘請顧問驗樓。
高铁拨款终于通过，政府说希望大家协助落实项目。
无论支持或者反对，我们相信大家目标其实是一致的，都是想为香港建设一个美好的将来。
遇难者遗体已经被找到，并将于近日。